What if creating content was as easy as typing in a topic? Well, Perplexity Pages might be your new best friend. If you don't know what Perplexity is, I suggest you watch my video tutorial here to get you started with the basics. Perplexity AI is one of my favorite AI tools. One of its outstanding features is the ability to cite and source information. It's kind of like ChatGPT meets Google Search, but way better. Well, they released a new feature called Pages, and it's a game changer. If you follow my channel, you know I do more than just YouTube. I also do e-com. I trade the stock market, and I write niche blogs. Remember when everyone was using AI to write their blog posts? It seemed like a shortcut to awesomeness, but whoa, things got messy real quick. Google started slapping tons of blogs, deranking them because the content, well, sucked. Why? Because most people were just throwing in a quick basic prompt into ChatGPT and then pasting the output directly into their blogs without even editing it. Big mistake. Here's the thing. Google doesn't hate AI writing, but they do care about blogs that actually help people, because Perplexity AI could cite the information and provide links to where it got its information from. It became a secret weapon for blog writers and their SEO rankings. However, it did require multiple work, such as asking a question, copying the answer, and rewriting it into a blog post. As for my blogs, well, AI controversy did get hit with the latest Google update, but it only lasted for about a month before my rankings recovered. My other blogs didn't get slapped. Now, with Perplexity Pages, you can now create your pages, including images and, yes, even including citation links. And it's even easier than ever now. I absolutely love this new feature. Even if you don't want to create blogs, with Perplexity Pages, you can use it to write your voiceovers as well. Let's take a look at how it's done. First, log into your Perplexity account. Full disclosure, I am on a paid plan. However, you should still be able to use this feature on the free plan. If not, it will be available soon as Perplexity is rolling this out. Now, to access Perplexity Pages, here where it says library, scroll over it and click on the plus button. You should now have a thread, page, and collection option. Go ahead and click on page. Now here it says, what's your page about? This is where you'll write your topic. And a cool thing we have here is a drop down called audience. This cool feature lets you choose your audience. Select anyone if you want to explain things in a super clear way. Choose beginners if you want to teach someone the basics, but they're still new to the topic. But if you pick experts, buckle up. You'll be writing for people who already know a lot about the subject, like your teacher. This means you can use fancy terms and dive deeper into the nitty-gritty details. And of course, here at the bottom, they have some samples. However, let's create a sample page. I'll do how to avoid taxes with offshore investment accounts. Relax, I'm just kidding. Let's use Google Trends to see what's trending. By the way, you're welcome for that sneaky tip. Well, for some reason, looks like how many rocks should I eat per day is trending, and it's up by 2,450%. So let's have Perplexity write a page about it. I have no idea what or why this is trending. However, I can't even keep up with humanity anymore. As you can see, just off the topic, it's now writing our page, giving a ton of information, even citing information here. How damn cool is that? You should not eat any rocks. Consuming rocks can be very dangerous and damaging to your health. Rocks are not digestible. You can cause serious harm to your teeth, throat, and digestive system. Despite a satirical article suggesting otherwise, there are no nutritional benefits to eating rocks. I know that's common sense, however, some of my comments I've been getting on my videos lately got me thinking otherwise. Okay, so it looks like there was a satirical article written by The Onion, which probably caused this search term to trend. It continues to write about health risk of consuming rocks. And here's an interesting subheading: AI struggle with satire detection. Well, looks like Perplexity AI didn't struggle with detecting it. Now, you can even have it generate an image for you. By default, it seems to choose a free photo. However, I believe we can spice it up with AI. Click here on the change button. From here, you can choose to generate an image. Here you can select different styles such as painting, photograph, illustration, and diagram. I'll choose photograph. Well, look what we got here. Now, I like this image way better than the stock image it gave. Let me adjust it. Masterpiece. Bro even got some missing teeth. from eating all that rocks. Now, check this out. To the right, we got our outline. And here you'll see that you'll be able to add a section and even add media. Here, you'll be able to move individual sections up or down and even deleting the section if you wanted to. Under edit, you'll be able to change the formatting media plus text or media only. You'll also be able to change it to a table or bullet points. If you scroll down, you'll be able to continue adding sections. Here, it even suggests what you should expand on. You'll also be able to change the writing from concise to detailed. As you can see, it kind of went off topic with this last section. So I'll go ahead and remove this section about AI struggle with satire detection. Click on more, then click delete section. Perfect. Now, let's say the section where it's about the health risks of consuming rocks, I'd like to change that into a table. Click on edit, then click on this table icon. Now click on the blue arrow icon. This section is now converted into a nicely formatted table. So here, under suggested, it looks like medical consequences of ingesting rocks looks like the next move. So let's go ahead and add that to this page. Perfect. Now, if you wanted to, you can add images. Scroll up and choose add media. Not feeling this image, so let's generate an image. Nice. Looks like Mr. Clean isn't missing teeth in this image. Maybe he's a beginner at eating rocks. I don't know. Anyways, you can continue to build this page as you see fit, adding more sections, editing existing sections, etc. When you're done, you'll be able to publish the page by clicking on publish. You can now share this link or create your blog or voiceover. You can also go back to this page and edit it if needed. As you can see, the related questions looks far better than the suggested ones they recommended during the page building process. So let's go back and edit this page to include these related terms. Click on edit, then copy and paste the related question to expand this section. Now you can see that it added the section into our page. The cool thing with this is if you share your page, you'll be able to share it with others who can then ask questions based on this page. Let me open an incognito window to demonstrate. You can then ask follow-up questions. Now, that's some cool stuff. Now, as far as posting this page directly to your blog to rank on Google, I'd personally make edits to it. I'd take that fully researched page from Perplexity and start using ChatGPT, Claude, or Gemini to rewrite each section. Use Grammarly to edit grammar mistakes, add your internal links and images, and you're done. Personally, I wouldn't take everything word for word straight from Perplexity. However, you could if you wanted to, do as you please. And if you wanted to use it as a voiceover for your video, just have Claude, ChatGPT, or Gemini rewrite it in a narration style. Also, if you're concerned with plagiarism, just use something like Grammarly's plagiarism checker. Looks like the page generated with Perplexity found no plagiarism, but it found 17 grammatical errors. Perplexity Pages is such an amazing new feature. If you enjoyed this video, now would be a good time to hit that like button and subscribe. Also, don't miss this video here where I go over the basics of Perplexity and how to use it. I cover pro features as well as a more in-depth look into Perplexity AI. I hope this video helped you, and I'll catch you on the next one.